I grew up in the 60s. If, like most of you may remember, the 60s was a really tremendous decade. There was a lot of social changes that was going on. We had the civil rights movement. And we were also in the midst of a war in Vietnam. In January of 1968, my family lost their oldest child, my brother. It devastated my family. I was 7 years old, and my heart was just completely broken. And to deal with that, I had nobody. We didn't have counseling at school. I was a first grader. There was no grief counseling to help me through this period, so I was pretty much on my own. So as that was the start of 68. That was the start of that year. And for my family, it started with a family loss. And for the country, in April of 68, we lost Martin Luther King. And a couple months later, we lost Bobby. And it was the second time that I watched my parents cry over the loss of these great leaders and also the loss of their child. So you can imagine a seven-year-old first grader going through the year dealing with this pain. And as the end of the year came around, and I knew it was going to be that first year anniversary, which is always the worst for a loved one. When you lose a loved one, that first year is the most painful. And I was not looking forward to that. You know, I was so sad. And in December, I heard about NASA. They were talking about this great mission, Apollo 8. It was going to be the first time that we were going to go outside the Earth orbit and go around the moon and come back. And I was excited about that. I was happy. And later, a couple of weeks later, Life magazine published the photo that Frank Bowman took as he went around the moon and coming back around, and he snapped that photo. And I remember my father walking in the house with this magazine. And I took that magazine and I just stared at it. And I was like one of Terry's kids with that wow look, you know, so excited about it. And it was at that moment that I knew I wanted to be a part of NASA that did incredible things. I wanted to be a part of that. Something that was not just for myself, but for the world. And I believe and I know in my heart that that's when I started to heal. The healing process started for me. And I also believe for the country and for the world, it was also a beginning, a healing turning point. And from that moment on, you know, I always wanted to work for NASA. I'm here today, and I've been working for NASA for 20 years. And I think that NASA has done great things, or is continuing to do great things. And what I want to challenge everybody when they leave here, my classmates in particular, that when you go back to your centers, that you continue to lead through the passion that you have for NASA, so we continue to do incredible things. Thank you.